Okay, I'm going to do a really basic, really short demo of a great piece of software I just discovered called Woodcraft. Now, if you're like me and you have little woodcraft projects that you like to do, benches and decks and things like that, this is a really cool app. It takes a little bit of getting used to because the developers at Faster who created this software took on a whole different paradigm, really wanted to model it after the way woodworkers actually work as opposed to the traditional CAD or 3D modeling approach. It is a 3D modeling app, but their approach is really different. So watch how we do this. I'm going to just launch Woodcraft now and start with new projects here. I'm going to just create a brand new project by hitting the plus icon at the bottom of the screen and then click on there to launch the new project. So here we have kind of like a typical 3D view. On the left we have our top view, which we could drag into this main area if we wanted to start by working in the top. You can see the top and the front view have switched, and there's a left view as well. So the three views give you a complete picture of what it is that you're creating. So I've just switched back to have the front view. In this demo, I'm just going to do a really, really simple frame, a mitered frame. It's going to show a couple of techniques that are essential, duplication and cutting and marking. So let's go ahead. The way you create new objects in this software is to actually go to your wood pile, which is this plus sign at the top of the screen, and you got your lumber's presets already here, and you can just sort of scroll through there. It's a really good idea, although you can create a custom lumber size by clicking the plus button at the bottom, it's actually a good idea to stick with preset sizes for later on, because one of the really cool things this app does is allow you to take a look at what wood you need to actually go and purchase, what lumber you need to purchase, and how much of it. And it keeps track of all that stuff. Even when you cut things off, it goes into a scrap pile. So you can really be effective, and you don't have to do that math yourself. So we're going to go ahead, and we're in the front view. So I'm going to create a box. I want the box to be visible. Sort of, I want the orientation of the box so that when we're looking at it from the top, we see all the four sides of it. It's actually not a box. It's just going to be a frame. Just keep it really simple here. So my front view, then, I'm going to grab a piece of lumber. Let's see. Should we make it both 2x4s? Let's do that. So here's a 2x4 here. And I always forget whether it's the underneath or below the marking. It's below the marking. So here we have one that's 2x4x96, and we'll just start by inserting a piece here. Okay, so that's there it is. We're seeing it in the front view, and if you look on the left, you see the top view and the left view as well. I'm just going to swap out the top view and the left view, and the first thing we're going to do is cut this sucker down to size. I'm going to pinch to zoom out a little bit. There we go. And not much to see here yet, so I'm just going to take this piece of lumber and I'm going to go ahead and cut it. I'm just going to switch to the 2D view. It's a little bit easier to work with by clicking on the 2D button at the top of the screen, and I'm pinching to zoom out. Okay, so over here the wrench icon is where you find all your cool tools. These are tools that are, again, modeled after traditional woodworking tools, not your typical 3D animation or 3D modeling tools. We're going to use the table saw because unlike the regular hand saw, the table saw allows us to be pretty specific and create cuts to specific dimensions. So here's the table saw. And what it asks you to do is to tap two vertices. That allows the table saw to know the alignment, the axis along which it's going to cut. So I want to cut down the length of this board, so I'm going to just click on this vertex and that vertex. And by doing that, it then brings up the cut indicator. And on the right-hand side, you're going to see the length of your cut as you drag the orange icon down. And you can see exactly how much you want to cut. So if I want my board to be, let's say, 20 inches long, I'm just going to move this up until it says 20 inches. It's snapping right now to a distance of half an inch. And there we go. So just click on the little cut icon here. Giddy up. So now we have the board is separated into two now. I can close this saw icon up. I'm going to click on the bottom half, which is now my waist. Double finger tap anywhere on the screen to bring up my contextual menu and cut. And that piece of board now has been cut, and I can zoom in here a little bit. Okay, so we're going to make just a really simple box. One of the cool things we can do here is we can overlap the pieces, and then we can perform our cut so we get a perfect miter join. The first thing that I'm going to do before I start duplicating and moving things is I'm going to go and turn snapping mode on. So the first thing we want to do is we want to snap to absolute grid here so that all of our objects will align. So I'm just going to move this, and as you can see, when you move it and you have snapping on, you get this helpful little grid overlay that just lets you know that snapping is turned on. Don't be confused by the grid. The grid itself is actually not to scale. It's not measured. It's just there as a visual reminder that you're snapping. Okay, so this guy is now snapped. I'm going to two-finger tap to bring up the context menu again and hit the duplicate button. So that's created a duplicate, and I'm going to carefully grab this orange piece, and you can see there I've now duplicated that. So I'm just going to move that out of the way. We'll bring it back in a second, and I'm going to duplicate this again and create my third piece, and now I'm going to just use a basically two-finger rotation gesture to rotate it. You can see that it's snapping to 15-degree increments, so it's really easy to see when I've got a perfectly horizontal board. All right, so I've now rotated the object, and I'm going to try to snap it into place. I'm going to move it up here, and you can see that it doesn't actually quite snap. If I zoom in, just the way the math has worked out, because it's using the center of this board as its current registration point, we're going to have to change our snap increment in order to get that to line up. As you can see, if I move it, it's going to go a little half inch one way or half inch the other way. So I'm just going to change my snap quarter of an inch grid snapping, and that should actually solve my issue. Okay, those two guys are now perfectly aligned on top of each other. And we're just going to line this guy up now the same way. Just zoom in to make sure. Pinch out to zoom out. And we'll duplicate the last guy by selecting it, double finger tap, duplicate, and we'll just move it down, drag it into place. Alright, so now I've got the basic frame. Let's take a look at that real quickly in 3D mode. This is kind of fun. They've done a phenomenal job of getting the tumble right. A lot of 3D apps don't really have this figured out, but you can see just how easy it is to tumble, and you can really get a good sense of your work here. Alright, we're going to pop out, and back into 2D view. Now we're going to look at cutting the miters on these guys. So the way you do this is by first you have to mark the corner that you want to cut. So let's start with this bottom right hand corner. And it doesn't matter which board is selected at this point. I'm going to go back to my tool menu and I'm going to choose the mark tool. The way the mark tool works is it wants you to select a vertex. Actually, it wants you to select two vertices, and then you can measure after that. So this vertex here and that vertex there allows me to draw my point out right to there, and then you hit the plus sign, and that's going to be the diagonal that you can see from the vertex I just created to the bottom right hand corner. That's going to be the angle I'm going to use with my table saw to make a perfect miter cut. So just before I do that, I'm going to go and grab the table saw tool, and just going to select both of those objects. Select the first vertex, boom, select the second vertex. Hey, where's my corner? And now I select the second board. That will actually allow me to cut both of those guys at the same time, which is really convenient and a good time saver. So now these two boards have been cut. I have to remove the waste, so I'm going to click on this piece here. You can see that piece is the waste from the horizontal board. Two-finger tap and cut to remove it. The second waste piece is a little harder to get at. You see that if I click on here, I'm actually clicking on the board. I'm not getting that waste piece. A couple of ways of handling this. One is by flipping the view. So right now I'm looking at it from the top. This icon in the bottom right hand corner allows me to flip the view and see the back of it. I'll have to deselect my saw first and flip it, and that should allow me to select that piece. If it doesn't, the second technique that I like to use is just to temporarily move this piece out of the way, select the other piece, don't delete it yet, and then press the undo button. One of the neat things here is the undo will undo the move, but it'll keep the current item selected. So now I can two-finger tap and cut it. Alright, so that's our first cut, first miter join, and we'll just do the same thing for the other corners. So we're just going to select our object, mark it, bring this down, One of the things that I learned was that cutting the object destroys any marks that are on the object. And so there's no point in marking all your corners first and then doing all your cuts at once the way you would do in the real world. You kind of have to do it one at a time. Not too big of a deal. Let's select both of those boards before I perform the cut and cut it away. And then once again, I can just cancel out of there. Select my waste piece, cut it, select this one, move it out of the way, select that, undo, two-finger tap, cut. And we're just going to move over here. Fast forward through this part. Okay, you can see that I've now performed the cut on all four corners. Let's just go back to 3D mode. You can see it there. Beautiful. The last thing that you might want to do with this shape now is you might want to nail it together. Nailing is kind of the grouping paradigm here in Woodcraft. So I'm just going to grab my wrench tool, go to the hammer, and with the hammer we can select all of these items and click the nail icon in the center, and that nails them together. That way when I come back later on and I want to select the frame, I can just click on it and it selects the entire frame at once. Do note that if you cut anything that's been previously nailed, similar to the way marks disappear, all nailed items get ungrouped again, and you have to group them again.